Very good evening to all of you. Today we are going to discuss about drugs that are used in gout. But before that, in this today's video, we will only cover about the pathophysiology of gout. So let's start with the gout. So here we can see gout is a metabolic disorder which leads to hyperuricaemia. So now, what is hyperuricaemia? The most important term that we can cover here, the hyperuricaemia. We know hyper that means excess, and uric that is indicating about the uric acid. So hyperuricaemia is excessive accumulation of uric acid in our body or in the joints. So and in some cartilages and organs like kidney. So uric acid. Accumulation of uric acid that causes gout. Now, uric acid is a waste product that is produced during metabolism of purines, that is RNA and DNA subunits. So, what happens? Excessive production of uric acid or reduced excretion results into increased level of uric acid into the blood. How the uric acid, level of uric acid increases in our blood? And the one thing is only happen, it can be caused just because of only two conditions. The first one is when the production is quite more enough in comparison to the its use, or another condition is when its excretion is decreased, when its excretion is decreased to a certain level. So this causes uric acid accumulation in our body. Now these accumulated crystals irritates the cartilages, causing inflammation and swelling and acute pain. We can see in the image over here, that is an image of a knee, and there's accumulation of uric acid crystals in the joints, which cause inflammation and swelling. Now it mainly occurs in middle-aged and elderly aged individuals. We can see it mainly occurs in middle-aged and elderly aged individuals, that we can say they are more prone to this disease. Now, who are at high risk? People with obesity, people having heavy alcohol consumption and dietary habits, which increases the risk of developing gout. So this is all about gout, or basic introduction about gout. Now let's move towards the pathophysiology. So now we have already seen that there is purine, and this purine is gets converted into hypoxanthin, and this hypoxanthin is gets converted in the presence of an enzyme, that is xanthine oxidase, into xanthine. So this xanthine again gets converted into uric acid. This xanthine again gets converted into uric acid, and this uric acid goes into the blood. Now here we are only talking about a condition of gout. So in the blood, and after that this precipitation of urate crystals in synovial fluid. Let me tell you, we are only considering about a condition where there's a chances of gout. So in after the blood, there's precipitation of urate crystals in the synovial fluid. So we can have a look over this image. So what happens here, this is a joint, and in here there's a synovial membrane, and there's synovial fluid. So this is a fluid that provides lubrication and support to the bone, and so that the bone can be movable very easily. Now we can see we can also see at the image that is on the right hand side. There is the same joint over here, but in this joint we can see there is accumulation of urate crystals over here. These are urate crystals that have been accumulated in the joints. So there is a precipitation of urate crystals in the synovial fluid, that is the synovial fluid, and this accumulation of this urate crystals. When there is accumulation of these urate crystals causes inflammation. So this urate crystals causes inflammation, and this there's inflammation that we can see that we can see over here, and that is the inflammation. Now this, when there's inflammation, there is accumulation of neutrophils or leukocytes. Now this accumulation of leukocytes and neutrophils at this this particular place of inflammation, this is the step that is infiltration of granulocytes into the joints, and after that there's phagocytosis of urate crystals. These neutrophils that is accumulated at the site of inflammation, this causes phagocytosis of monourate crystals, and this monourate crystals and simultaneously there is damage of tissues. Damage of tissues which causes generation of free radicals, and those free radicals also damages the tissues, and the damaged tissues causes there is release of glycoprotein. This glycoprotein triggers there is release into a process that causes this increase in acidity, acidic pH. There is increase in acidic pH, and there is release of lactic acid. When there is release of lactic acid, this again triggers and causes there is more precipitation of urate crystals. When there is again more precipitation of urate crystals, these urate crystals causes the acute gout again. So this is all about the pathophysiology. We can see over in the